Hey guys, it's me Ben from 6++ here with a little painting tutorial video. So you may have seen recently we put out a battle report with Craftworld Eldar versus Black Legion, and in that I used my custom Eldar, which is a Mymeara variant colour scheme with this sort of blue-green colour shift. So we're going to jump right in and take a look at how I achieved that. Alright guys, so here we are with a little Eldar Guardian to show what the scheme looks like in the end. As you can see, it's slightly different to the GW Mymeara scheme in that I've got a white helmet that I chose rather than the black. I thought that just popped more. But the basics are the same, so we've got a light blue blending into a green with a very bright blue edge highlight there to really make it pop. So to achieve this, we start off with black. This is the piece that I'll be working on today, so that's just done through the airbrush with Vallejo black primer, but you can use any primer with the brush or not. Then we go for a nice base of Temple Guard blue. So that's the first colour. Next up we've got Coelia green shade, which is for all the recesses on your model. And then this is the special sauce, the magic stuff, Waywatcher Green glaze. GW doesn't actually make this anymore, and they might make a variant of it, but I found that you can achieve a similar effect with Warpstone glow, just watered down with a bit of Lahmian medium. You can even do it with water if you want to. So that's going to give us that kind of nice glaze over the top, and then finally we edge highlight with Baharroth blue. So let's jump in to the first steps. Alright, so I've loaded some Temple Guard blue into the hopper there of my airbrush. It's mixed with a little bit of flow improver and a bit of water, and the consistency we're going for is just like that. So it's a little bit runnier than the original paint. Not too runny. Temple Guard blue is quite a tricky one in the airbrush. It tends to clog, but if you get your mix right, if I can show you again, then you shouldn't have any problems with it. This is one of the things I found trickiest with airbrushing, is trying to get that mix right. And I think just doing what I'm doing now, testing it against the side, you can kind of get a feel for how the consistency should be there. Okay, so I'll start off with spraying this piece here. I'm spraying about 40 to 50 psi, so quite high. I'm just doing these short, sharp bursts. As you can see, from about 3 to 5 inches away. Just giving that nice coat all over. Now, with my vehicles, if you have watched the battle report, Eldar versus Black Legion, you'll see a lot of my vehicles, I actually leave the tail ends quite dark, almost black, because I wanted to go for even more of an interesting dynamic colour shift from the bright blue or green through to blue through to black. But for my troops and other infantry and things like that, I've just gone for the blue-green because it does get a bit busy. And yeah, it's a nice way to kind of differentiate between those two. So with this piece, I will leave the tail end a bit black. You'll be able to see the exact same technique going on here. And that's what we've got so far. It's looking pretty good. I'm going to keep going with a few more coats, make sure it's dry. You can see it's quite wet there because of the mix. I probably could have gone a little bit thicker, but yeah, I'm going to keep going with this, drying it off. You can always use your airbrush without pulling back, just to dry it off quite easily. And yeah, so I'll finish that off and come back with the next step. Okay, so after quite a few coats to get that nice and solid and smooth, this is what we are left with. So nice smooth coat of Temple Guard blue there. And next up, we've got the special sauce, Waywatcher Green. I love this glaze, it's really, really nice. Again, shame that GW aren't making it, but as I said, Warpstone Glow works as well. We're gonna do Waywatcher Green for now. So, loaded up into the hopper here, and you can see this doesn't really need, oops, not the camera there, sorry about that. So loaded up into the hopper there, you can see it. And this doesn't really need much dilution because it is, as you can see, pretty pretty runny straight out of the pot, but I've put a little bit of water in there, kind of almost out of habit, but also I think it's better to err on the side of caution, go a little bit lighter, thinner, and then you can always put extra layers on. Right, so again with this, we're gonna just direct the paint towards the kind of top third of the piece. And this goes on kind of faster than you think it might. So you can be quite careful with this. Try and get that in frame there. This is the sort of distance I'm actually spraying from. Airbrush is just slightly off camera. And as you can see, I'm turning the piece as I go, not overspraying onto one section, especially with a really diluted paint, because then it will look terrible and you will start clogging up details and things like that. And you do want to be subtle if you can, but you also, you know, want the effect to be noticeable. So that's why I just do things very carefully, bit by bit, layer on layer. That's the amazing thing about the airbrush. So the same technique can actually be applied with dry brushing. So it doesn't come out quite as smooth, but if you take your time with it, you can still get a really, really good effect. I'll probably have to do another video on that to show how that can be done, because I do appreciate not everyone has the space or the money or the inclination to have an airbrush. You can see again, what I'm doing here is actually just using the air to dry off this really, really diluted paint. And you should be able to see, yeah, you can start to see it there, the colour shift. I've missed a mould line, very bad, Ben. But the painting's fine, I think. So you can see it start to go there. So we could leave it at that, but I want it to be a bit more noticeable. So I'm just going to put a few more coats on. I haven't actually changed my PSI here, although my compressor is actually off, so I'm losing pressure. But I'll keep the PSI high just because it means you don't get as many clogs. And if you're careful and you, you know, practice your trigger pressure, you don't actually need to drop that PSI down particularly. You can do if you want to, but I find it's not always necessary. Right, I'm going to finish that off. It's already coming together quite nicely. I'm going to finish that off with a few more coats and we'll see the finished result. Okay, so that is all done now. So as you can see, we've got the nice colour shift from the green. I've gone quite dark, quite strong, I suppose, with the green on the end there. And you'll see I've also just made sure to catch this bit here. So a lot of models and vehicles, you will have, you know, different levels. And we've got to imagine this is actually a paint scheme that the Eldar have decided on. It's not some sort of naturally occurring thing. So you want it to hit, you know, all these different parts, because if it ends here, it does look a bit strange. If this is just blue, kind of looks like it's been, you know, dipped in a load of green. And that's not as effective, I don't think. So yeah, that's how we do the initial part. It's basically done now, but to make it really pop, we can pop double pop there. To make it really nice, we can put the Coelia green shade into all of the recesses there, and then we can edge highlight with a bit of Baharroth blue as well. All right, well, that is it. Just a really quick tutorial to show you how this effect is achieved. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please, you know, like, comment, subscribe, follow, all that good stuff. And check out the Eldar versus Black Legion battle report where these guys feature, because I've got a lot of different units in there, and you can see how I've applied this effect to a whole army of Craftworld Eldar. So that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and have a good one.